Welcome to the video lectures on course radiation and microwave techniques. We are going through unit 4, that is passive microwave components, and this is the lecture 5th in which we will see the two more ferrite devices, that is isolator and the circulator. So let's see what are the contents related to isolator and circulator that we are going to cover in this video lecture. Starting with learning outcome, the isolator's symbol, S matrix, construction and working. And of circulator, we will see the symbol, S matrix, construction and working. And along with that, we will also see the applications of circulator and how these circulators, they are used in the various applications. So starting with learning outcome, after completion of this lecture, students will be able to understand the isolator along with its construction and the working, understand the circulator with its construction and working, and they will understand how to use circulator in different applications. So let's start with the lecture with the isolator. So an isolator, it is a two-port device which provides very small amount of attenuation for transmission from port 1 to port 2, while provides maximum attenuation for transmission from port 2 to port 1. This requirement is very much desirable when we want to match a source with a variable load. So let's see the symbol. This is the port 1 and port 2 of isolator. As I said, the signal it passes from port 1 to port 2 without any loss. But when it passes from port 2 to port 1, the signal is totally attenuated. So you can see the symbol representation of isolator is in such a way. Coming to the S matrix, port 1 and port 2, they both are perfectly matched ports. So S11 and S22, they will be equal to 0. And if we consider input at port 2 and output at port 1, we know we get total attenuation, so output will be 0 at port 1. So S12 will be equal to 0. And we know when we apply input at port 1, we get some output at port 2. So this S21 will be equal to 1. So as I said, S11 is 0, S12 is also 0, S21 is 1 and S22 is 0. So this is the S matrix of a two-port isolator. So in most of the microwave sources, the output amplitude and the frequency, they tend to fluctuate very significantly with the changes in the load impedance. This is due to the mismatch of source output to the load, resulting in the reflected wave from the load. So consider there is a microwave source and there is a load, and the signal passes from microwave source to the load. But if there is a impedance mismatching, that is if ZL is not equal to Z0, that is the load impedance is not equal to the characteristic impedance, the signal it gets reflected. To avoid this, what we do, we place an isolator in between the microwave source and the load. So you can see isolator, it is placed in between the microwave source and the load. The signal from microwave source passes through isolator to the load, while if there is any impedance mismatching, whatever is the signal reflected, it is absorbed by the isolator and it does not go towards the microwave source. Because this reflected waves, if they reach to the microwave generator, they will cause amplitude and the frequency instability of the microwave source or the generator. Let's see the construction of isolator and then the working of isolator. For this, a rectangular waveguide is taken. Near to the port 1 of this rectangular waveguide, a resistive card is placed. We will see what is resistive card. So a resistive card is placed near to the port 1, then the waveguide, it is twisted mechanically with 45 degrees, and in the further dimension of waveguide, a ferrite rod is placed. And near to this port 2, there is again one more resistive card which is placed. So in this way, the isolator, it is constructed, and We will see how its principle, that is the signal from port 1 is passed to port 2, while the signal when it is fed from port 2, it is totally attenuated and we get zero output at port 1. So to understand this, we will see its working. First, we will see what is this resistive card. This is the new thing. So the resistive card, it has the property that it allows unattenuated propagation if the electric field of the wave it is perpendicular to it, and it absorbs the entire energy if it is parallel to the card. So remember this point, this is important while understanding the working of isolator. Consider a signal is applied to port 1. Again, that signal is nothing but a dominant TE10 mode is excited in the port 1 with the electric field vector, which is vertical. This vertical electric field now passes through this resistive card, but you know that this resistive card, it allows the propagation of electric field which is perpendicular to it. So you know now here this electric field, it is perpendicular to this resistive card, so it will allow this electric field to pass through it. Then this electric field vector, it now enters into this mechanical twist and it gets rotated by 45 degrees in the anti-clockwise direction, and the electric field then it enters into the ferrite rod, and due to the ferrite rotation it gets rotated again by 40 degrees in the clockwise direction. This makes the electric field vector again vertical. And the signal then it passes through this resistive card. Now you know this electric field, it is again perpendicular to this resistive card, so the signal it will come out of the port 2. So this action, what it says, that if the signal is entering from port 1, it is coming out at the port 2 without any attenuation. Now to understand the characteristic of isolator when the input is provided at port 2 and output is taken at port 1, that is we don't get any signal at port 1. The whole signal which is fed at port 2, it gets attenuated and there is zero output at port 1. So how it is achieved. So consider a port 2. This is a port 2 which is excited with the TE10 mode. The electric field will be vertical. When it passes through this resistive card, you can see that this electric field vector, it is perpendicular to the resistive card, so it will allow this signal to pass, and then this signal will travel down to the ferrite rod where it gets rotated by 45 degrees in the clockwise direction, and now this signal then it passes through this twist where it again gets rotated clockwise by 45 degrees, making the electric field, you can see over here, it has now become horizontal. So now when this electric field vector, when it arrives at this resistive card, you can see this resistive card and this electric field vector, they both are parallel to each other. So this electric field, it totally gets absorbed and there is no signal that will appear at the port 1. So in this way, this total signal which was fed from port 2 is absorbed and there is no output at port 1. Now here you can pause this video and you can check the explanation of this isolator from port 1 to port 2 and for the port 2 to port 1. Now coming to the applications of isolator, these isolators, they are used for isolating transmitters from antenna, isolating two stages of amplifiers, or for isolating local oscillator from mixer. So these are the various applications where we can find this isolators. Now we will move on to the second part of this lecture, that is on a circulator. So what is circulator? Ideally, a circulator, it is a n-port device, or it is a multi-port waveguide junction in which a wave can flow from nth port to the n plus 1 port in one direction only. For example, say if input is applied at port 1, the output will be at only port 2. If a signal is applied at port 2, the output will be only at port 3, and in such a cyclic manner, the output is circulated. And in the circulator, there is no restriction of number of port, So in general, we will see first the three-port circulator. In that, first we will see a clockwise circulator. You can see this is the port 1, port 2 and port 3 of circulator. As I said, if input is applied at port 1, we get output only at port 2 and there is no output at port 3. Similarly, if input is provided at port 2, we get output at port 3, and if input is applied at port 3, we get output at port 1. So it is very simple to write the S matrix of this 3-port circulator. It will be a 3 by 3 matrix. So here we know when input is given at port 1, we get output at port 2. So this S21 will be equal to 1. If input is provided at port 2, output is taken at port 3. That is S32, it will be equal to 1. And you know when input is given at port 3, output is taken at port 1. So S13 will be equal to 1. So in this way, the S matrix of a clockwise circulator can be written. Now let's move to the anti-clockwise circulator. Just the difference is the signal will rotate in the anti-clockwise manner. That is, if a signal is provided at port 1, it will only appear at port 3. If the signal is applied at port 3, it will appear only at port 2. If the signal is provided at port 2, the output will appear only at port 1. So let's write the S matrix of this anti-clockwise circulator. As I said, if a signal is provided at port 2, we will get only at port 1 the output. So S12 will be equal to 1. If input is provided at port 1 and if output is taken at port 3, then this S31 will be equal to 1. And if the signal is fed at port 3, output is taken at port 2, this S23 will also be equal to 1. So in this way, the S matrix of the anticlockwise circulator, it can be written. It is easy. Now we will see a 4-port circulator. So a 4-port clockwise circulator is shown. If input is given at port 1, only at port 2 we will get output. If input is provided at port 2, we will only get output at port 3. If input is given at port 3, we will get only output at port 4. If port 4 is provided with input, we will only get output at port 1. In this way, this 4-port circulator, it works. Let's see how to write the S matrix. As I said, if input is provided at port 1, we get at output at port 2. So this S21 will be equal to 1. If input is at 2, output will be at port 3. So this S32 will be equal to 1. If input is provided at this port 3, the output will be at port 4. So S43 will be equal to 1. And if input is at port 4 and output is at port 1, that is S14 is equal to 1. So in this way, the S matrix of a 4-port circulator can be written. Now moving on to the construction of 4-port circulator. 4-port circulator, it can be made by using magic tea and a non-reciprocal 180 degree phase shifter. So now let's see the construction of 4-port circulator. So here a magic tea is taken, you can see. And in this, here there is a circular transition and a ferrite rod is placed along this waveguide. This is port 1, port 2, port 3 and port 4 of the magic tea. Now let's understand the working of the 4-port circulator. For that we will take the case that when input is provided at port 1, we only get output at port 2. So consider the port 1 is excited with a T10 mode, and this signal, when it passes from rectangular to the circular waveguide, that is through this circular transition, it gets converted or translated into TE11 mode, and the orientation is perpendicular to the orientation of this port 3. So output at port 3 is 0, and the signal then passes through this ferrite rod, which rotates the signal by 45 degrees in the clockwise direction. Then this signal now is out of phase from the port 4. So output at port 4 is also 0, and further this signal comes out of port 2, which is exactly in the same phase as that of the input at the port 1. So in this way the signal passes from port 1 to only port 2 and not to the port 3 and the port 4. Similarly, consider the input as provided from port 3, that is port 3 is excited with a TE10 mode. When this signal it comes to this ferrite rod and passes through the ferrite rod, it gets rotated by 45 degrees, and when it gets rotated, its orientation is in the orientation of this port 4. So input at port 3 is circulated to this port 4. Similarly, if input is provided at port 2, we get output at port 3, and if input is provided at port 4, output comes out of the port 1. You can pause this video and you can see the signal passage from port 3 to port 4, and the similar it is applied for port 2 to port 3 and for a signal passing from port 4 to port 1. Now let's see the applications of circulator. Circulator can be used as a duplexer. Circulator can be used as a duplexer for radar antenna systems. So for here, a three-port circulator is taken. Transmitter is connected to port 1. The radar antenna is connected to port 2, and the receiver is connected at port 3 of the circulator. So whenever the signal is to be transmitted, the signal is applied at port 1. This is a clockwise circulator, so if the signal is applied at port 1, it will pass to this radar antenna, and this antenna, it will act as a transmitting antenna and it will transmit the signal. Similarly, when this antenna, it receives the signal, that signal comes to port 2. As this is a clockwise circulator, the signal will appear only at port 3. And at port 3, the receiver is connected. So the powerful radar transmitter, it is isolated from the sensitive receiver. And the same antenna, it can be used for transmission as well as the reception of signal. So in this way, the circulator, it is used as a duplexer. So second application is circulator can be used as an isolator. For that, again, a three-port circulator is taken. You know, isolator, it is a two-port device. So one of the port of the three-port circulator, it is terminated with a match load. And you know, if a signal is provided at port 1, it will appear at port 2 only, and there will be no signal from port 2 to port 1 in the circulator. So here the power loss from port 1 to port 2 is less, that is the whole signal is passing from port 1 to port 2, which is called as insertion loss, and power loss from port 2 to port 1, it is more, that is none of the signal is passed to the port 1 from port 2, which is called as isolation. So in this way, the circulator can also be used as an isolator. Hope in this video lecture you have understood whatever we have discussed. We started this lecture with the isolator. We have seen its construction, working, and then we have moved on to the circulator. We have seen the three-port circulator, four-port circulator, its scattering matrix, and then we moved on to the construction and working of four-port circulator, and we also saw the applications of circulator as a duplexer as well as for the isolation purpose. Thank you.